10 different color wigs all in my closet, feeling just like Dennis Rodman. Different color bills all in my pocket, feeling just like Dennis Rodman. 10 different color wigs all in my closet, feeling just like Dennis Rodman. Different color bills all in my pocket, feeling just like Dennis Rodman. Yeah, 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 feeling just like Dennis Rodman.
So guys, today I'm starting off with this short bog wig from Rosa Beauty, and I'm using their 10-inch lace front human hair wig. I'm just gonna pull it out of the bag right now. I'll be sure to leave all of the information on this wig in the description box, but this is just a close-up on the frontal, showing you guys the knots here, which of course I'm about to go in with bleach. I did want to note that this wig is only a lace frontal wig and not a full lace front wig, which I'm showing you here. Putting that to the side, you're going to need a bowl or something to place your bleach in. So I'm just using this one and some quick blue bleach. And then I'm going to go in with the only developer that I have. I wouldn't recommend using 40. If you're OG, you know that I love using 30 volume developer. I feel like it's beginner friendly and you can easily fix your mistakes. However, the only thing I have is 40 developer today, so I'm going to be using that. It works just as good. Just be sure not to leave it on as long as you would with lower volumes. I won't lie, I was a little cautious, specifically because I'm using a higher volume today, so I definitely went in a little bit at a time. The consistency you want is gonna be super thick. The best way that works for me, literally, is you want it to penetrate, but you don't want it to soak into your lace. So I'm using this, honestly, I feel like people use this for icing. I have no idea what it is. I just found it in my sister's kitchen. And I'm just going to literally start patting it on. As you can see, you should be able to pick it back up, literally. It should be that thick to where it doesn't seep through the actual lace, but it'll still penetrate and bleach the knots. Now, if you get a little bit in your wig like I did, it's okay, it'll all rinse out. And honestly, ain't nobody finna be looking inside your wig cap anyway. If you don't have this in your house, usually I just go in with a plastic butter knife and just take your time, bounce it all in there. In the end, it should look something like this. So I ended up using this blue-black dye from Jazzling. Is it Jazzing? Whatever, I always use this growing up. So I decided to go back to an OG. And literally, I just flip the wig over while the bleach is still on the frontal. And I'm going to just start using this on the edges and baby hairs that I feel like would have gotten a little bit over bleached. I'm just going to go ahead and start counteracting that. I did get a little nervous because I saw a little bit of green. So I rinsed this off probably within the next 10 to 15 minutes. I didn't show it here, but I used purple shampoo to rinse off the bleach, and this is basically what I've got. It looks super duper natural and amazing, not the bleach ton, and now I'm ready to dye my hair. So I'm going in with that same blue black color, and this time I'm focusing gently on the baby hairs and the edges because I want it to sit on the front of my head the longest so that it's the darkest, if that makes sense. And I really just wanted some super jet black hair because jet black hair is just so grown and sexy, and I want to feel grown and sexy and short there. So basically, I'm just taking this throughout the frontal. As you can see, I did get it a little bit on the frontal, but it's okay because you can rinse it out. And I'm just taking this from root to tip on the wig cap. Thank you. the rest of this process is pretty explainable. I'm literally just taking the rest of the dye and I'm going to be applying it straight to the hair strands from tip to end, combing it through, rubbing it through with my hands. Pretty explanatory. But I did want to give you guys a little bit of information on Rosa Beauty as well as the hair that I received. I feel like this wig is super easy, very comfortable. The sides fit perfect, which is something I've noticed a lot of wig companies have a problem with. The wigs being way too big or the lace front having to cut it off. I realized it was super easy to apply. The only thing that I do not like about this wig will be the texture. If you guys were looking for a dupe for the curly wig that you guys saw on my Instagram, I definitely would say this is similar, but it's a different curl pattern. However, it's still pretty. I'm able to achieve that wet look, as you'll see at the end of this video. And yeah, it does not give you much shedding. It does not tangle. It's a super easy, natural, manageable wig, and I'm really, really glad that I got it. So after a glass of wine, I rinse this off and start plucking my baby hairs. If you guys need an in-depth video, I'll leave it in the clicker. And that's pretty much how I achieve my wigs, you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you need information on how I install my wigs, I have a mini series up. And thanks so much to Rosa Beauty for sponsoring this video. I will see you guys in the next one.